Throughout this course, we'll be getting you involved in a lot of these interactive coding exercises. And the idea is that you're not just sitting here watching me talk, that you're actually putting everything you're learning into practice. That way, it actually becomes your own. These coding exercises are great because we can give you instructions and show you what should happen if you write the correct code, what it needs to do, and you'll be able to write your code as well as see it run in the console. And it's through a lot of these exercises that you're going to level up and you're going to become a better coder. So in order to enroll, head over to this URL, and if you don't want to type it in, you can head over to the course resources and you'll be able to get a direct link there. And the first thing I want you to do is to go ahead and click on the fork button. Now, the important thing here is this is the output that we want to see down here in the console. And when you hit run, this is what should happen. Now, remember that I want you to have exactly the same characters printed out as I've got here, including where the spaces are, including the symbols like these single quotes, etc. Now is the time for you to head over to this challenge and try to complete it. Pause the video now and complete this challenge. All right, how did you get on? I really hope you gave this a good go because it's in these moments where you're going to be learning the code. Unfortunately, no amount of listening to me talk is actually going to give you these skills. It's only when you actually try it out and get the computer to do the thing that you want it to do. That's when you become the master of the computer, also known as a programmer. So in this case, the instructions are pretty simple. We have to use what we learned about the print statement to output these three lines. And notice how in this GIF, the lines are printing out in separate lines. This one gets printed, then this one, then this one. But because it happens so fast, it seems like as if they're getting printed as a single block. So we're told to write our code below this line. And we know that in order to print something, we use the print function with a set of parentheses. And inside the parentheses is where we tell it what we want it to print. So in the first instance, it's day one, space, then it's... Now, it's really easy to make spelling mistakes, but I really encourage you to actually type out anything that you put into your code rather than just simply copying and pasting it. Now, of course, it works exactly the same way. I could just copy and paste the code in here, but it's often in these cases where you make mistakes, like, for example, forgetting to add the double quotes around the text that you want to print. I really recommend just typing out the code for practice whenever you're doing these code challenges. Now, the last line that we want to print is a little bit complicated. It's almost like print inception, because what we want to print is this function. This is how we write our function. And that has to go inside here, inside a set of double quotes. So let's open up our double quotes and then write our print statement. And in this case, I'm actually using a single quote, and I'll tell you just in a little moment why that is. So let's add that single quote and finally the closing parentheses. This now is the entire code that you would need to be able to print something out. And when I go ahead and click run, you can see that the output looks exactly the same as what we've got here in the GIF. This is what we want, and I've now completed the coding challenge. Now, coming back to this single quote, why is it that I've got a single quote here rather than a double quote, which is what we've been using all this time? Well, because in Python, it doesn't actually care whether if you enclose these strings, so these pieces of text that are not to be interpreted as code, inside single quotes or inside double quotes. It is identical to the computer. This honey badger literally doesn't care. But if you had a set of double quotes and then you wanted another set of double quotes inside the double quotes, so for example, if I replace this with double quotes, you'll see that already the syntax highlighting is already screaming out to us. There's something that's not quite right here because the colors are not the same as here, where the print function is in a particular color, the parentheses are in a particular color, and the text that is to be printed is in a yet another different color. In this case, it looks all jumbled up and we're getting some errors here. So now if I hit run, you'll get syntax errors. And the problem here is, of course, this is, of course, our code thinks that the end of this string is here. And so it doesn't know what on earth is going on afterwards. And instead, it's seeing this as a string, and this is being interpreted as code. So when we want to use some double quotes inside another set of double quotes, commonly you'll see people switch to single quotes instead. So you could, for example, write the print statement like so, and use double quotes if you want to print those out. Or you can do it the other way, which is what I had before, where we use our double quotes on the outside and single quotes on the inside. So have a play around with that if that's at all confusing. But once you've tried it a few times and switched it around a few times, it should become clear what it's actually doing. How did you get on with this challenge? If you ever need to see the solution, it's always down here as a link. So if I go ahead and paste that link into my browser, then you'll see word for word the solution to each of these challenges. And hopefully that'll help you along the way while you're learning as well. So I hope you enjoy this challenge. In the next lesson, we're going to get back to learning about Python and we're going to learn about strings and string manipulation. For all of that and more, I'll see you there.